All right, next on the show, we have Sharon Haver. She is a style and personal brand expert. She is also the founder of FocusOnStyle.com, which is a website for female entrepreneurs who want to step into their star power and attract high-level clients and those opportunities. Welcome to the show, Sharon.
Thank you for having me.
Yes. You look great. You both look like there was no snow outside. I don't know how you pull it off.
I know.
Well, did the limousine drop you off up front?
We kind of had a little something about Mary hair getting out of the cab. But
share with us. You say that you're a personal brand expert. What does that mean exactly?
Well, I started out doing my own personal brand. So many, many moons ago, I wanted to be in fashion. And my mother was like, no daughter of mine is in fashion.
You won't make money.
You won't make money. You're going to have to be in the garment center. So I have a degree in marketing and business and PR and branding. And they didn't even call it branding back then. And I was a stylist for 15 years on photo shoots. I was pretty well known. I did everything from Vogue covers to making polyester sweats look so good. And then I had a newspaper column on a newswire that went out to 400 papers. And that was kind of, I realized that my business brain was sort of setting me forward as I was transitioning my career. And then when I had my son, I kind of found myself online. And that was back in 1999. He was a newborn, and it was a long story. But basically, I had to create a website like overnight. And that was more than 15. I can't do that. I don't want to do the math
anymore. Don't do the math.
It was 1999. So what happened was, I started FocusOnStyle.com back then, and it was a style site, and it was a continuation of my column of giving stylist advice, but I kept needing and wanting to use my business brain and realizing that I was creating my own brand, that I was doing my own business. So what happened as the site progressed, I started helping other entrepreneurs develop their own brand and their own business, not realizing that I was even doing it for myself because it just kind of came naturally.
Beautiful.
All these entrepreneurs are bold and fearless.
Yes.
I feel like I sometimes, and my dad always tells me, no, you are an entrepreneur, you're doing what you're doing, but a lot of this is fearless, what you were doing, because your parents told you.
Or stupid, like you didn't know.
Don't go into fashion.
Do that.
You're never going to make it.
You're not
that thick Northeastern accent. Yeah. You're never going to make any money.
You're going to be with a bunch of Clementos. No way.
So was it really ignorance or belief in yourself, a mix of both? What was it?
No, going with my gut. So maybe that is a belief in myself. But basically, I really believe in going with my gut. I'm not a dreamer. I'm not a projector of things I want to do. I kind of go with my gut with what feels right and how I transition my career. And I think part of it is, especially now with the internet, positioning is the new currency. So you need to position yourself to get what you want. And I just sort of subconsciously do it by, you're getting tired of something, you want something else, you're looking in other directions, so you sort of position yourself for the next thing, and it kind of happens because you're doing all the work without actually working. I know I hate air quotes, but it's true. It's kind of like you're setting yourself up, you're positioning yourself for the next thing, and your eyes are open, so you're aware and you're alert, and you know what's going on, and you're there.
All right, so for the female entrepreneurs who are watching today, what are the three staples that they need to have in their closet?
I don't think anyone needs a staple.
Okay.
I think that everybody is different. Everybody has a different style. What you need to have is something that's on brand for you. So if you're a business coach or a finance coach, you shouldn't be looking like a yoga professional. So I think that's
the look matters.
You know, you shouldn't be coming out looking like you just cleaned the carburetor when you're talking about somebody like elevating their revenue, right? So you need to look on brand, and you also need to look like you and be authentic. And then, because, you know, everyone else, they hire stylists. You know, why hire me? I want to, like, empower women to figure it out themselves. So, like, when they put their hand in the closet every morning, they find a dress when they're redesigning their website. They have the fonts. It's all the same, the look, the image, the brand, it all goes together. And the third thing would be being in tune with who you are. And in this visual world that we live in, your headshots are so important to how you're perceived. And that's why I created a program called Simply Amazing Headshots. And I have a free cheat sheet called How to Look Great in
Photos. That was my next question, because both genders. So
the thing is, it's not what you wear, it's how you wear it, how you position yourself.
So just a quick, some points from the cheat sheet. So I'm on vacation, or even just you know, you talk about headshots, but pictures in general. What does a good picture look like?
It looks like you. It looks like you. It doesn't look like you're retouched and Rembrandt, like, put it on the internet.
Or it's not your college photo.
It's not trying to look 26. Right? Oh, my God. Right. Yeah. You know, everybody looks 5 years younger in a five-year-old photo, but, you know.
Yeah.
But when you walk,
which is why we like those photos.
Exactly. Yeah. But when you walk in the room, you need to look like you. It's really simple. So you need to sort of look on brand, look pulled together, look polished. And right now, how you present in that way is totally part of your toolkit as an entrepreneur, because we're all doing stuff like this besides just being on Facebook. You know, when you're watching us on Facebook, everyone else could be doing it too. So you need to, you know, have someone that's aspirational, that looks relatable, that looks like you, and you are the best at being you, and you're not trying to be somebody else online or, you know, walking in a networking event.
Do you have those hard conversations with people where you literally have to say, look, this was a great picture 25 years ago? Actually, you'd be surprised.
You would be surprised. Because, you know, not having style, not being in touch with your photo, I say, is a lot like BO. Like, nobody knows they're the one who stinks, right? They're like, oh, it's somebody else in the room. It's like, you know, my photo. It's like, no, it's great. Or like my outfit. Oh, no, it's great. It's usually people come to me or find Focus on Style or enroll in one of my programs or as a client when some moment comes when they have that click and they get it. Because you can't bring, what is that expression, a horse to water, whatever, you know, it is. Like, you can't tell someone, so they have to suddenly feel that they're not, like, something's amiss, and then they're able to go and find, you know, and change themselves and elevate themselves.
Sharon, we're out of time, but you illuminate the reason why I love New York, because it's just, like, straight to the point.
Your
picture should look like you. Stay on task. Follow your gut. All fabulous advice.
Thank you.
Say the name of your website one more time.
It's FocusOnStyle.com, and my new book is Style Word, and it's all about quick New York minute quotes. All sorts of call to actions. You got howtolookgreatinphotos.com to get the cheat sheet. You got the book, Style Word. You got Focus on Style, where you'll find everything.
Sharon, so nice to have you on.
Thank you.